Now, what is an extreme form? An extreme form is a creative form, okay, that has one technique or more, okay, where you spin past 360, okay, or do an inverted technique, okay? Now, 5 to 7 years ago, they used to create in the rules that said you had to do a certain amount of techniques. They don't do that anymore, okay? The reason why is because beginners don't know how to do all of those movements, all those techniques. They used to say you had to do a kick past 360. You had to do an inverted movement. Okay, you used to say that. They don't do that anymore. They just say, if you do one technique that is not appropriate for the creative division, it automatically makes it eligible for the extreme division. So if you just do one move that's extreme, legs go over your head, or you kick past 360, then it's deemed as appropriate for the extreme division. Okay, so just one technique is all it takes. Does that make sense? Okay.
There's no limit, though.
I'm sorry?
There's no limit to how many extreme techniques.
There's no limit to how many extreme techniques that you can do in a form. Okay, generally speaking, you're going to want to see a blend and a relationship between the martial arts techniques and the martial arts application and the flips and the tricks and the acrobats. Okay, so if there's no relationship, okay, then you're not going to give the competitor a high score. There has to be a relationship. Okay, if it's just tricks, that means there's no relationship. There's nothing to evaluate other than tricks. Does that make sense? So you have to see a relationship between the flips, the tricks, the punches, strikes, and the kicks. Does that make sense? Okay, so that's an important distinction there too. Okay, so in terms of extreme forms, what are you allowed to do? Okay, very little limitations to what you can do in the extreme division. Okay, you can do gymnastics, traditional tumbling gymnastics that you'd see in the Olympics. You can do that in the extreme division. Okay, you can do acrobatic kicks. Okay, 540s, 720s, 1080s. Okay, 1260s, 1440s, okay? You can do any of those acrobatic kicks. You can do movements where you're tricking, or you're going inverted, feet are going over your head and spinning. You can dance, okay? I mean, there's a lot you can do in the extreme division, okay? Very little that you cannot do, okay? The only thing that you really cannot do is do a form where there is no martial arts relationship, okay? That's pretty much the only guideline that you have in the extreme forms, okay? Now, one thing that it says in the rules is it says obviously a form with more acrobatic or more extreme movements would be scored higher than somebody that only has one acrobatic or one extreme technique. Okay, but again, you're not just judging the extreme tricks. You're not just judging the punch, strikes, and stances. You're judging the relationship between all of them. Okay, and that's the biggest challenge that I see judges judging these divisions. Okay, is because they want to just fix it on the tricks. Or they say they have a bad attitude about it and say, well, I don't like the tricks because that's not what I do when I did martial arts, so I'm just gonna judge the stances. Okay, but you can't do that, okay? You know, that's like, you know, reffing a football game and saying, hey, I'm old school, I like to run hard, I don't like this new aerial passing attack, so I'm just gonna throw flags on all the passes. Okay, you can't do that, okay? So ultimately, you have to judge the relationship between the flips, the tricks, the stances, the punches, the strikes, all of it. Okay, that's very important, okay? Extreme weapons. The same thing as extreme forms, okay? The only difference is because it's a weapons division, you're going to be evaluating the weapons manipulation in relation to all of the other acrobatic techniques, okay? So is the competitor doing solid weapons manipulation in conjunction with the flips and the tricks and the stances and the punches and the strikes? Are they integrating the weapon in an effective way with all of those punches, strikes, tricks, and flips, okay? So in extreme weapons division, look for that integration, not just the flips, not just the kicks, not just the punches and strikes, the integration of all of it together, okay? So when they do that 540 kick, are they just doing a 540? Or are they doing a 540 and that bow staff goes between the legs and they spin it around the neck and then they pose? Does that make sense? Okay, so you're looking for the integration of all of it together in the extreme weapons division, okay? All right, any questions on extreme weapons? Ken, why don't you do your crescent kick aerial combination. This is just an easy demonstration here of extreme weapon. Okay, so that would be an extreme weapons combination, okay? Again, you're looking for the relationship between all of the movements, okay? Is the weapon manipulation integrated with the flips, the kicks, and the tricks? Okay?